Hi friends, how are you all doing today? I hope you all are doing safe at home. I'm Dr. Sriranjani Bhatt, an Ayurveda consultant from Ayush. I've also done a previous video regarding safety measures, what you can take during corona times. In this video, I would like to add few more points into the topic as well as talk about a new topic that is called as Ritu Sandhi, which is an Ayurvedic concept. So shall we begin with the topic today? So the first word what I would like to emphasize on is about Nasyam or Pratimarsha Nasyam. According to Ayurveda, Nasya is nothing but an act of instilling nasal drops in your nostril. So this practice of Pratimarsha Nasya was carried out even in olden days as a part and parcel of their dinacharya or daily routine. Maybe in those days the people were not aware of why it was done, but it was indeed helping them to protect themselves from various infections. So why not we make use of this procedure and protect ourselves as well as our family from various infections what we are going through today. So how it is done? So let me explain. So this Pratimarsha Nasyam can be done by instilling just one or two drops of either plain desi ghee or coconut oil or sesame oil, which is called as Tilatailam in Ayurveda. Or else you can even instill two drops of Anutailam. Anutailam is a medicinal nasal drop. You can just put two drops in your each nostril and take it inside. So when do you carry out this Pratimarsha Nasyam? This Pratimarsha Nasyam can be done at least once a day. It can be even done multiple times a day. But before leaving from your house, as well as after you come from some other place inside your house as well, you're supposed to do Pratimarsha Nasyam. So the second point I would like to emphasize is about the importance of tulsi leaves. I'm sure many of us have come across this word tulsi leaves in our day-to-day life, and we know how important it is. Tulsi is said to reduce your respiratory issues. It is said to increase your respiratory immunity as well as reduce the stress levels. So this herb can be made use, maybe utilized by taking 3 or 4 leaves of tulsi and boiling in 1 liter of water. This water has to be boiled for some time, say for around 10 minutes, and this water has to be used for your regular consumption throughout the day. I'm sure it is going to help you boost your respiratory immunity. So these are the two points which I wanted to add in my previous video as well. The new topic which I would like to explain is nothing but Ritu Sandhi. Ritu Sandhi words, that is Ritu and Sandhi. Ritu is season and Sandhi is joining. So according to Ayurveda, there are 6 Ritus. They are Hemanta, Shishira, Vasanta, Grishma, Varsha, Sharat. So in between these 6 seasons, there is a junction. How the junction happens? That is 7 days in the end of the previous season and 7 days in the starting of the next season. These 14 days is said to be a Ritu Sandhi Kala. So during this Ritu Sandhi Kala, a lot of emphasis is given in Ayurveda, where a person has to be very careful regarding the food he has, regarding the diet what he does, regarding the lifestyle what he does. These all play a very important role for dosha balance. So you may be asking, what is dosha? According to Ayurveda, there are 3 basic elements, that is Vata dosha, Pitta dosha and Kapha dosha in every living being. So when there is imbalance of any particular dosha, there would be a disease in the person or that living being. So generally, these 3 elements are commonly existing in all the human being. It's only when the imbalance happens due to the poor lifestyle or due to the excessive intake of food substances which increase the particular dosha, or doing the practices which increase a particular dosha, only then the dosha increases. So there are some things like in every season there would be either a dosha predominance or there would be accumulation of one particular dosha. Say for example, during the Vasanta Ritu, which is called a spring season, Kapha dosha would naturally be in a predominant state, that is Prakopa state. So during this season, one has to be very careful regarding the ahara what he takes. So he has to avoid the food which increases the Kapha dosha. The food which increases Kapha dosha are generally madhura rasa, that is sweet, amla rasa, sour, and lavana rasa, that is salty. So these three rasa yukta ahara has to be taken in moderation to control the kapha dosha. As well as a person should avoid sleeping in the daytime. Day sleep in Ayurveda is called as divaswapna. This act of divaswapna tends to increase kapha dosha. So please don't do divaswapna during the vasanta rutu. And what food he can take? So that would be the next question. The food items which are katu tikta kashaya rasa yukta. Katu is spicy, tikta is bitter, and kashaya is astringent. So these three rasa yukta ahara he can include plenty in his diet. As well as he can do some form of exercise, at least 30 minutes to 60 minutes of exercise, daily walking, I'm sure is going to reduce the kapha dosha in the body. What are signs and symptoms which says that is generally person feels heaviness in the body, or they feel drowsy, lethargy, lack of energy. All these suggest kapha dosha is in a predominant state. So there is one more rutu, nothing but rainy season. During this rainy season, naturally there would be vata dosha predominance in climate itself. So a person has to reduce the foods which increases the vata dosha. That includes dry food, which are stale or previous day made food, the food which are cold in nature. These things have to be avoided. Instead, a person should take a lot of food which are warm, fresh, homemade food, including slightly ghee in them. So that's how he can control the vata dosha. And one more lifestyle what we commonly do these days, that is sleeping late in the night. Sleeping late in the night, getting too stressed out, emotional outbursts, all tend to increase vata dosha. So please avoid these things. He can also drink hot water frequently throughout the day to control the vata dosha. Varsha Rutu, naturally, they will come across so many patients with joint pain, muscle pain, and all vata jet disorders. So as well as other people also, I would like to advise this vata reducing diet during the Varsha Rutu. So we are talking about Ritu Sandhi, and I started explaining about the individual Ritu and diet, what you can do in some of the Ritus. So Ritu Sandhi is the 7 day previous Ritu and 7 days in the starting of the new Ritu. So currently we are in Ritu Sandhi between in Vasanta Ritu and Grishma Ritu, that is spring season and summer season. So as how I spoke earlier, Vasanta Ritu is a time when kapha dosha increases, and Grishma Ritu is a time when the accumulation or vata dosha happens. That is Sanchaya of the Vata Dosha. There won't be any Prakopa in a Vata Dosha. Time frame, I would highly advise you to have Kapha and Vata reducing diet. As how I discussed earlier, in the food you can have, so that you can follow here. This Ritu Sandhi is a time when naturally a person is more prone for various infection. His immunity is said to be slightly lower compared to the other times. As to gradually reduce the diet of the previous Ritu and gradually increase the diet of the new Ritu. So all at once one is not supposed to dump himself with the new diet or dietary or the lifestyle regimen. So friends, I hope the procedures and tips whatever I have told has been of some help to you. Please make use of them. Protect yourself as well as your family against various infections, and stay at home and stay safe. Next episode, I would be coming up with a new topic. Until then,